Good, everybody. Connor McIver, welcome to our Truth in Lending Thursdays. Exciting show. We did yesterday, on Wednesday, we did talk about foreclosures and getting that better than average deal. There are discounts still available out there, but it's going to be up to you to find that right representative that gives you the information that you need. And if you don't have someone like that, make sure you listen to yesterday's show and find out what is out there for you to hire. What is out there? So look for that. I'm Connor McIver, local real estate agent headquartered here in Santa Clarita Valley, serving greater Los Angeles and the rest of Southern California. This is, you found, our daily housingradio.com radio show. Housingradio.com. While there, you'll be able to see everything. It's not a super deep website, but it gives you all the necessary tools regarding anything you may be interested in within the real estate realm. As far as what properties cost, you can search the actual multiple listing service. We have all the permissions, so it's not going to be like looking at one of those real estate syndication websites where more than likely you're going to have all of your personal information taken and sold to other people, people willing to pay for it. That's not what housingradio.com is. Plus, you'll be able to listen to all of our past radio shows. We have thousands, literally thousands of real estate radio shows that we've done since 2004. Been in the business since 1998. We're on Twitter at Housing Radio, facebook.com/housingradio. If you're on LinkedIn a little bit, you got to throw an extra /in/ in there. But you can go to linkedin.com/in/housingradio. Pinterest, Housing Radio, Instagram, Housing Radio. You get the picture. We're housingradio.com. Please check us out online. I think you'll enjoy the systems. Want to know what your house is worth? You can do that as well. So this last week, kind of to give you a little bit of a recap, this last week we had our Market Monday broadcast, and we did get into the local inventory of what's going on. A lot that we are getting additional units for sale out here. In fact, every day there are new listings posted. SCVNest.com is going to be your access point for that. SCVNEST.com. You'll be able to see all of those new listings that have entered the market. At the moment, they do. Registration is required, but like I said, nobody's going to be spamming you or selling your personal information because why? Well, I have the radio show. I have the team. I have the license. I want to be your representative whenever you're ready. Let's talk about the last 7 days in history during our Market Watch segment here of the show. Big numbers on the board. New listings, 132, have hit the market in the last 7 days within the Santa Clarita Valley cities. And while we work in greater LA and Southern California, Santa Clarita is a focal point for us. And it's a smaller snapshot of the greater picture. If we're seeing this many units, and again, per week we were seeing 50, 60 additions, now we have twice as many real estate units entering the market for sale in a 7-day period than we have had in months past, and this is going to track all the way back to last May and June when we saw this much inventory entering the real estate market. It hasn't happened in a while, folks. And just as I had opined, we're going to get more and more listings on the market for sale in the next few months, as is indicative of every year at this time. This is very typical for a real estate market. The balancing act is this. If you are a real estate seller, somebody that's out there trying to sell your property now, you need to make sure that your pricing's right because you're about to see competition. More competition than you had. Now, is it going to be enough to flip this market from being a seller's market where we are 100%, no doubt about it, nobody can argue that point, today into a buyer's market? Time will tell. 132 new listings enter the market this week. That's twice as many as what has been normal in the last several months. Price change 41. 41 properties have had their prices changed. I opine that we will see that number also start to change and morph and actually increase as we get more listings on the market for sale, because what's going to end up happening, people are going to hit that panic point. If they don't have the right advisor, they're going to say, oh my gosh, maybe we're priced too high. Oh, Larry down the street, he's selling his house. Marge, oh my gosh, you put hers up for sale. What are these people thinking? I just wanted to sell my house. That's the panic point. Watch out for that. Don't do that, folks. If you're selling real estate, make sure your advisor sits you down and explains that panic is not a good part of the equation when it comes to selling anything. You have to be standing by. And also, there are ways to advertise and market above and beyond what the multiple listing service does, above and beyond what they say when your listing is going to be syndicated to HubSpot and Zillow and Trulia and all these different syndication platforms. There are better ways and other ways. Also, depending on whom you're working with is going to depend on their own personal database. That database could be key because people are coming in through this particular agent in the way of buyers, and they're going to be able to offer you more of those resources as well. Buyers that they know that they have a relationship with. Maybe these particular buyers happen to be on the fence, and because of their relationship with this agent, the agent that you hired, your house will actually sell to somebody, to them, or to somebody in their sphere of influence. You don't know. But these connection points, everything matters in real estate. 29 properties actually fell out of escrow, coming back on the market for sale. 52 properties entered the backup offer status, meaning they went into escrow. 12 properties expired, not selling within contractual timeframes. So basically, somebody takes a listing, puts it on the market. After they get that listing on the market for sale, there's a certain amount of time that goes by. And then during that certain amount of time, the listing does not sell. It does not finish the actual process. So what ends up happening is the listing expires. So let's say you had 12 months, a listing contract for 12 months with a particular agent or 6 months. It went through that entire time frame not selling, so therefore it expired. We have 12 of those. 66 properties went into pending status. That's also escrow. It's a much more secure form of escrow, but it is escrow. 76 properties actually closed escrow and sold over the last 7 days. That's the real estate update. Now, today in Truth in Lending, people ask, well, what's about interest rate? What's about interest rate? So we're going to show you. Online resource, we did put a system in place to kind of give you an idea, well, not to kind of give you, to kind of to show you where this particular interest rate is. So if you go to goscv.com/rate, what it'll do, goscv.com/rate, what it'll do is it'll take you to our Paris 911 site. That was the original website for Santa Clarita Real Estate that we put together. On that page, so goscv.com/rate. That'll give you an idea where the interest rate is. I want you to look to the right side of the page as it loads, and the page will probably load different if you've been here in the past. This is bankrate.com is what it is. I basically forwarded that URL, but leaving our contact information at the top of the page, you can send me an email once you're on this page if you're interested. And moving forward, we'll make those introductions to the best lenders out there. We are not lenders, we are realtors, but we know the best lenders in the business just because that's a necessary part of 99.9% of our buyers because they are using financing. So I can tell you, if Bank of America is going to be the best in this case, Wells Fargo, a mortgage broker, I can tell you which lending institution is going to be better than the others. Something to look at. And make sure you ask. So if you go to goscv.com/rate, on the right side of the page, you're going to see the interest rates. Mine loaded under the refinance tab. Maybe it knows that I already own real estate. Maybe. You want to click on the mortgage tab. So you'll see mortgage, you'll see this is under compare rates, okay? And under that, you'll see mortgage, you'll see refinance, you'll see auto, you'll see CDs, you'll see checking slash saving. That's what you'll see. You want to click on mortgage, and I mean unless you're doing a refinance. And then you're going to look, we do have an interest rate increase. 30-year fixed, 3.68%, and that's up 0.02 from last week. Not a big change. And again, throughout the rest of this year, I don't see a big change happening either. Interest rates are still very low. When you go to a lender, that's what you want to say. Mr. Lender, how do I get this interest rate that I saw on Connor McIver's site or on bankrate.com of 3.68%? And then they'll explain to you how you get that rate. If your FICO scores are good, debt-to-income ratio is good, everything looks good, you should be pretty darn close to getting that rate. You need to ask them. If they're charging you more than that, substantially more, and their justification sounds shaky, then what you want to do is seek a second opinion. Same thing, you go to a doctor, and even a doctor, for the most part, isn't going to be costing you as much money as it is to purchase a house. Houses are expensive. You know, back out here, average price point in Santa Clarita Valley, somewhere in the $400,000 range. Lots of money for that, right? Usually when you go to a doctor, the procedure, $100,000, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000, $1,500, you know, depending on procedure, $10,000 at the most. Now we're getting into the cosmetic realm. But when you go to the doctor and you ask them for their opinion, they say something that sounds funny. Oh, yeah, no, you need evasive surgery. You need all this stuff. You're going to go out there and you're going to maybe ask another doctor, hey, what do you think? This is what Dr. So-and-so said. What do you think? Same thing with regard to interest rate. You go to a lender and they're spinning you this tall tale about why your interest rate's going to be 5% when everybody else is paying today 3.68%, you should go ask someone else, another lender. How you do that and keep your stuff secure is you make sure that that very first lender you inquired with is giving you the intel with regard to your report. You want to get your whole credit report from them. Besides a credit report, you also want to get copies of that. You also want to get a good faith estimate. So ask the lender for those items. That's where the interest rates are this week. Of course, we do have our Friday finale show coming up. Tracking Back Wednesday. Good show. Got to listen to that because it does give you, as buyers and sellers, some advantages to use. Today, as a seller tip, as we always harp on, make sure you're really getting those good values on your home and the information that's being produced to you. Pre-listing. Make sure you see it all. Ask for it. I want to see a copy of your sales contract, Mr. Agent. I want to see the comparables, Mr. Agent. I want to see all of the information that you can provide to me with reference to you selling my house. I want to have that up front so I can look at it, Mr. Agent. That's what you do. And have them send everything to you. Even before that first meeting, set the appointment, that's fine. But make sure you have everything. So you have a chance to look at it so you can get all your questions answered. That's smart business as a real estate seller. We automatically do that. I get a call, somebody says, you know, I've been thinking about selling my house. I said, all right, what's stopping you? And they tell me, well, you know, we need to find the right person. I said, all right, well, give me your address and tell me what you owe. Tell me what you've done to the house. Give me an idea if you're selling to buy, if you're selling to, you know, jump ship and leave California, whatever it may be, let me know, and then we'll work it out from there. Very simple. But if they have in their email, within hours, they have everything. They have all the contracts, they have all the comps, they have all the real estate reports, title profile, they have everything they need to make a good decision. And it's not just sent to them and then I walk away and meet them at their house and say, okay, it's for sale now. I actually explain it. That's important. Talked to a lady yesterday, took a listing there in Canyon Country. Her problem with the previous agent had to do with non-explanation and her feeling that he was going to run out of patience because she had a lot of questions. In fact, seeing signs that he was running out of patience. So I'm not trying to train anyone because I have a lot of patience, but her past agent did not. That's sad. You should be able to sit and spend time with people and work through whatever situation they bring up. That's really important when it comes to buying and or selling real estate. I'm Connor McIver. Thank you for listening. We will be back tomorrow, Friday finale, as stated. We have our Sold Saturdays coming up this week, our Open House Sundays. And access point to that is going to be Santa Clarita Open Houses.com. You can find us online, housingradio.com, Twitter, at Housing Radio, facebook.com/housingradio. Hook up with us, and please do me a big favor. Share the show. Share the show to people that need it. A little bit longer than normal today. I'm sitting in front of Flare Cleaners here in Valencia, across from Town Center. Also at Housing Radio, see some of our own listings. Click on the tab, Our Listings, up at the top left part of the screen. You'll see one that, in fact, the condo that we're selling across the street in the Madison Town Center is awesome. Great price. Fourth floor overlooks this entire beautiful area here in downtown Valencia. So you got to check that out. Town Center Drive. We have one for sale there. Connor McIver, have a great day. We will talk to you soon. Be safe. Over and out.